In this video, I create a Weblay modification of an edge of the simplex. So I start here, and the first thing what I do is I want to get an edge of the simplex, so I need the edge node, freecat edge, and the input is the shape out here. So, and I want to see this edge, so I select the object here and I say I visualize it, and once more I have to calculate it. And now having this, I have here the edge and I can change the color bit and make it stronger. So this is the edge. So I also can change the number of the edge. In this case here I have the attribute index, and when I change here, execute it, then I see this now is h1 in the index, and that means h2 and the naming convention. So okay, having this edge here shape out, the next thing what I want to do is I want to discretize it, so this shape is in wire. I create a discretize object and I say I want in this case 10 points, and I want to display it. So once more I have to recalculate it all, and now I have here the discretized edge, so we can see here the points. And in the next step I add a randomized polygon, and in this case I use the outcome here as shape in. I have here some factors, and the shape out here I want to display, and I see now here this is the result. So when I change here the parameters, I have a factor inner and a factor ends. This is the random factor for this curve, and now I change here the inner vector, the inner randomness and the outer randomness. If I set factor ends to 0, that means that the randomized polygon goes to the endpoints of the shape in, and if I make it larger, then the endpoints go more inside, and the inner factor I can make it very large. Okay, so I have a randomized polygon from the endpoints. I set this back to 0, this kind, and now the next step from this randomized polygon, I want to create a spline, a curve, B-spline curve. I use the points as input, as poles from the B-spline curve, and I say I want to display the curve. I calculate it once more and I calculate the B-spline, and now we see here this is the B-spline. We now can hide the randomized polygon, and we see here the B-spline curve, the resulting curve. And now we can play a little bit with the configuration. We can now say we connect this chain randomized to the B-spline, And we can look when we change here the inner factor, then the curve changes in the same we have here in this direction. We can stretch it and we can press it together and so on. And this is the way to modify one of the edges of the tetrahedron to get such wobbly edges.